This vase records a successful battle. This open mouth vessel was used for paint. This painted vase shows God El in the underworld. This vessel was shaped like a howling dog. You are looking at a vase decorated with part of the Maya zodiac. This figurine is dressed as a warrior and a ball player. This figurine is dressed as a warrior. The Maya used this incensario to burn incense. This painted vase shows a sacrificial dance. This vase shows the god of death. Here is a carved bottle. This painted vessel shows a ball player. This head shows the god of the number zero. This vase shows artists at work. This plate shows an artist painting a Mayan book. You are looking at the vase of the seven gods. This vase records the history of a war captive. This vase shows a scene from the palace. This vase is decorated with weaving patterns. This vase shows a lord coming to pay taxes. This vessel was shaped like the fish monkey god. This figurine is wearing a duck bill mask. These ornaments are made from jade. This trumpet was made from a conch shell. This stone lintel comes from Yashilan. This stone lintel comes from Yashilan. This vessel shows the face of the monkey god. This vessel offers a good example of sculpted pottery. This figurine shows a woman weaving. This figurine represents a dwarf who served the ruler. This figurine shows a ruler in costume. This figurine shows a ruler on his throne. This incensario was used for burning incense.
Imagine yourself an acolyte entering the passageway under Structure 8 in Bekan without the benefit of flashlights our MayaQuest explorers enjoy. Pitch black, even in the middle of the day, This maze likely related to the Mayan Mitnal, or Nine Underworlds. How did the nine underworld gods, the Bolontiku, figure into their rituals?
Across the empire lie observatories where priest astronomers tracked the stars. As the sun set, they looked skyward, climbing to perfectly aligned observatories. Their minds and souls must have filled with wonder and duty, for their observations were intimately tied to the keeping of time and the calendar for religious ceremonies. So exact were their measurements that many sites have buildings that put on special shadow shows at the equinoxes. Venus, associated with battle, was carefully charted. A mix of the scientific and the spiritual, Mayan astronomy still fascinates today.
The Maya shaman oversees ceremonies and practices healing rituals for the villagers. Here, we are privileged to witness a healing for a man suffering ear pain. On the table are candles and gourds filled with liquids and crystals. The shaman waves a chicken and herbs over the man's bad ear while chanting prayers. The chicken is cooked and served with tortillas, and the chicken entrails with the contents of the gourds are carried out and poured into the entrance of a deep cave. In contrast with medical doctors, the shaman concentrates on helping people fit into their towns better and bringing them into balance with the world.
Between North and South America lies one of the most intriguing land areas on Earth, Central America. This tropical Eden of lush rainforests contains wildlife that is unequaled for variety and mystery. One bizarre insect is the human botfly. It is an insidious flying demon that causes misery and loss to humans and other mammals of this region. The female botfly is an efficient parasite that uses us to take care of her babies. The first victims of the botfly are other flies and mosquitoes. She catches them and glues her eggs to their undersides, often in midair. These temporary hosts and hostesses land on humans. The eggs hatch from the warmth of the skin of the next victim. The larvae are now called maggots, or bots. The growing larvae dig into the victim and cause the skin to itch. As this MayaQuest explorer learned, they develop into large, draining boils.
Oh.
The bot would have stayed with her for about 2 months had it not been removed. If not taken out, the bots will eventually leave their victim and fall to the ground. There, they will continue to develop from maggots to pupae, and on to adults, ready for the next victim.
Biking during MayaQuest offered many challenges. Extra strong tandem bike rims and 36 spoke wheels proved so durable they lasted for the entire trip. Sealed components, safe from the humidity, sand, and mud, reduced the need to carry spare parts. Biking up to 80 miles a day, the team usually started the day with fruit and drinkable yogurt. The terrain was very demanding, and occasionally there were injuries. The off-road biking was a spectacular environment, the solitude mixed with the hum of insects. Entranced by the scenery, we weren't always sure where we were.
Where are we? Belize?
Thank you.